Kashmir, sir, and it is found in nail sheep, sir, found in Rajasthan and Haryana. Bakhalwala sheep found in Jammu and Kashmir, and dry saddle sheep, sir, found in sorry, sir, New Zealand, sir, sorry, and Baluti, sir, found in Iran and Pakistan, sir. Sir, this one is only, sir.
Okay, you have done a good job, but I asked you from the Indian breeds, right?
Yes, sir,
Give
some
the
are
priority
from.
for the Indian breeds.
Yes, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
When you said that different types of animals, but Kunal told are only sheep.
Sir, can't see the screen and your voice is not clear.
My voice is not clear.
Sir, your voice is clear only. Sir,
And what about the screen?
definitely, sir.
It's not clear. Sir, I can't see the screen also. I can't hear properly.
So, okay, just check your network connection.
Yes, sir. Sir,
Excuse me, sir. Sir, you asked us to write different animals.
Sir, I can't do, sir. Animals
are okay, sir.
Yes, sir,
Sir,
but
but he told the breeds, different breeds of sheep.
Sheep.
Sir, you told it is black
Okay, I
and
told you
brown.
to find out the 10 Indian breed sheep, which will give us as the wool.
Oh.
Sir, no, sir, you told us to find animals producing wool.
10 different animals which
Oh,
produce
different
wool.
animals.
Okay,
Oh.
okay. Okay, whatever the homework you have done, just tell me on that one, okay?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I'm Pranav. Can I tell?
Yeah, next one. Wait. Ritvik? Ritvik, are you there? Ritvik, ready.
Sir, sheep.
Okay. Yeah, you can start.
Sheep, goat,
Okay.
camel,
Okay.
rabbit,
Okay.
yak.
Next.
Sir,
Yeah, you
rabbit
can
was
continue.
antelope. Antelope.
Hmm.
In the northern states, in the Arunachal Pradesh, antelope.
Okay, good.
Mountain goats.
Next.
Musk oxen.
Okay.
Angora rabbit.
Yeah, you can continue. You can say the list, complete list.
And llamas.
Okay, good. What about the pranav?
Yes, sir, I'm telling.
Yeah,
10
start.
Indian breeds of sheep which gives wool. Nali sheep, Chokla sheep, Marwari sheep, Magra sheep, Jaisalmeri sheep, Malpura sheep, Sonadi sheep, Patanwadi sheep,
मुजफ्फरबाद
Muzaffarnagar. Yes, sir. Muzaffarnagar sheep, Jalauni sheep.
Good. Aditi?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yama, sheep, goat, guanaco, vicuna, Patanwadi sheep, yak, camel, alpaca, and lohi sheep.
Good. Raghav?
Yes, sir. Sheep, goats, llama, camel, rabbit, muskoxen, yak, alpaca, merino, vicuna, Kashmiri goat, Angora goat. Yes, sir.
Jait, next, good.
Yes, sir.
You can turn on your video, right?
Sheep, goats, Angora.
Guys, you can turn on your videos first.
Send me videos on.
Your voice is not clear, Jade.
Sir, sheep. Sir, my video is on.
Your voice is not clear, Jade. I will ask you in the
Thank you,
last.
sir.
Just check your connection.
Sir, not
Internet connection.
clear.
Shiva Pranav? Shiva Pranav?
Sir.
Shiva Pranav, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what is the answer? What is the homework you have done?
Sir, hello?
What is the homework? I asked you to find out 10
Sir, I can't
Indian
hear
breeds.
you.
Sorry?
I can't hear you, sir.
You can't hear my voice. What about others?
No, sir. I can't.
Sir, we can hear you, sir.
You're audible.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, two children are messaging in the group for you to accept their request.
Okay, I'll check that one now. Thank you.
Now can you hear me?
See, at my side, there is no issue at all. Just check your internet connection first.
Sir?
Yeah. Okay.
Well, let's start the class, sir.
Hear me now?
So, what about the remaining candidates?
Sir? Sir?
So, just raise your hands. How many have you done the homework? Raise your hands in the Zoom meeting. How many of you done the homework? One minute, please. Hello.
Sir,
we can't hear you. Sir, is it clear
now? Yes, sir,
we can. We can hear you, sir.
And Jade, we can hear you also.
Okay, thank you, Raghav.
So, how many have you raised up? Just raise your hands. How many have you done the homework?
Sir, I have raised.
Only 11
sir,
people.
Sir, can I talk to you now?
Please ask me, sir.
What about others?
Sir, Jayid.
Cyrus, Nikhil, Harini, Jagruti, Sahit Verma, Shiva Pranav, Shruti Patel.
Sir, Nikhil, this is the first time I'm attending
this class. Sir, even for me, this is my first class.
Okay, okay, no problem.
Even for me.
So, what about others?
This is also my first class, but I have.
Sir, can I show Shiva Pranav?
Okay. So, your remaining candidates, you can do that homework in the next class. Along with the today's homework, I will give some other homework for you. Okay, we'll start the class now.
Okay,
sir.
So, last class, we discussed about the fibers. What is the animal fabrics are there, right? What is the fiber?
Sir, can we lower our hands?
Yeah, you can lower your hands. What is the fiber first?
Sir,
can I say fiber?
Yes, what? Sir, I completed. So yesterday I had a little inconvenience because I left, but I completed, sir.
Yeah, what is a fiber?
Sir, fibers are natural and synthetic. Natural fibers are
sir, fibers are two types, sir. One natural fiber and one non-second
synthetic
fiber. Man-made fibers are synthetic fiber like that, sir. Mm-hmm. And natural fibers are like wool.
Land. Excuse me, sir. Sir, can you ask each and every person individually? Because when one is answering, another person is speaking.
So, that's only I'm doing, right? I'm asking you individually only. Okay. So, don't worry. We'll ask you everyone. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
So, what is a fiber first, Kunal?
Yes, sir. Sir, fibers are of two types, sir. One natural fiber and one man-made fiber.
What
sir.
Is the classification of fiber? I'm asking, what is a fiber?
Sir, the fibers are made by, our clothes are made by fibers, sir. The thin hair of animals, sir, like our hair, sir, with that we can make any dress, sir, like that. Yes, sir.
See, fiber means what? The thin hair-like strand.
Yes, sir.
Strand. Fiber is nothing but the thin hair-like strand is called as a
fiber.
Okay. Yes. Suppose if you are combining the group of fibers and twisting, then only it will form the yarn. From the yarn, you can make into the fabrics.
Sir, can I tell examples of fibers?
Okay. Afterwards, we'll discuss that one.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Next one.
Sir?
Ahana Singh, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what are the examples of synthetic fiber?
Sir, examples of synthetic fibers can be like
So can I?
Ritvik?
How about nylon and rayon?
Yeah, good.
Sir, can I say?
Wait. Already she told the answer, right? Okay, Ritvik, next. So cotton is made up of protein or cellulose?
Cellulose.
So in the growth of hair, which protein is important?
Sir, keratin.
Keratin. Good. Next, Pranav. Not Pranav. Wait. Aditi, is it? Aditi?
Yes, sir.
So, which protein helps in the formation of silk?
Fibron and...
Your voice is not clear.
Sir?
Which protein helps in the formation of silk?
Silk. Fibron and
sir, can I say?
Shruti?
Can you hear me?
Wait, Shruti, are you there?
Yes, sir.
So, which protein helps in the formation of silk?
Sir, sarsin and fibroin.
Sarsin and fibroin. Aditi?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, what are the different types of hair present in the animals?
Fleece, fur. And bristles.
Bristles.
Quills.
Quills, good. Sri Vallabha?
Yes, sir.
So, what is a fleece?
Sir, fleece.
You can turn on your videos first. Okay, what is a fleece?
Sir, can I say?
Yeah, next one.
Sir, can I do the mixing?
Sorry?
Sir, can I tell?
Can I tell?
Mahavir, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is the fleece?
Sir, fleece is a soft, woolly substance. Sir, it's produced from sheep.
Okay. What, Harini?
Yes, sir.
What is the use of bristles? What is a bristle and where will you use the bristles? Pass.
Sir, can I say?
Sir, Harini said sir, that she is first class, sir. This
okay,
is
okay, sorry.
Sir, can I? Sir, can I tell?
Yeah, who is this? Sir, just raise your hands.
Sir, can I tell Aditi?
Shruti?
Sir, can I say?
No, who didn't give the answer? You can say that one. I have given chance to some people, right, already?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I didn't.
Sir, Pranav Raghavendra.
So you can lower your hands first. Lower your hands first. Till now, I didn't give chance to anyone. Those people can raise your hands. Kunal, I have already given you chance. Vallabha, I have given the chance already to you. Just lower your hands.
Yes, sir.
Those people till now didn't get the chance to say the answers. Just raise your hands.
Okay. Sir, what is it? Sir, can you repeat again?
Raghu?
Sir, not Raghu. The question asked by
Shri. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, what is the bristles?
Yes, sir. Bristles are short. They can be thick or thin, but they are really stiff. Example, squirrels. And they are used to make brushes.
Good. Example, sir.
Sir,
Okay, we will continue with the topic. Afterwards, I will give you a chance, okay? For the remaining people.
Okay, sir.
So last class we had discussed about the properties of wool, right? What is a fiber?
Yes.
What is a kemp?
Yes,
and how to differentiate between the wool and the cotton?
Yes, sir.
So today we'll discuss the quality of the woolen fibers. So generally, in which season we will use the woolen fibers, woolen cloths?
Sir, in winter.
Sir, in winter, sir.
Sir, in winter.
Winter. When we wear a fluffy or some type of fat jacket, we will not feel too much cool.
Because these woolen fibers are the act as a good insulators, right?
Yes, sir.
So it will not transfer the heat from the surroundings to the body, or else it will not transfer the heat from the body to the surroundings. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
It will act as a good insulator of the heat.
It is a bad conductor, sir, because the...
Yeah, bad conductor of heat, or also insulator also, you can say. Insulator also same.
So that the heat doesn't pass from the woolen object, so we feel warm in the winter.
Yeah, good. So next we'll discuss the quality of the wool.
Wool traps air.
Yeah, that all the things we'll discuss in this topic, okay? So first what? Wool fiber is soft. We know that one. Either it can be thin and the long and crimpy. So whichever wool is more crimpy, we'll say is that is the best quality wool. If the wool is more and more crimpy, it is a superior quality.
Sir, what is crimpy, sir?
Fluffiness, smooth.
Okay. Sai Kartika is messaging winter.
Okay, leave it that one. Understand.
So what is crimpy?
Crimpy is nothing but the smooth and the fluffiness.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, if you take the kemp, there is no crimpy material at all in the wool. Because kemp is a waste one, right? It's just a part of a fleece, waste part of the fleece.
Yes, sir.
So, you can see here. Crimp in the fleece makes it bulky and fluffy. So, whenever there is a more crimps in the wool, it will make the wool as a more bulky as well as fluffy and the smooth. Okay?
Sir, once can you scroll it up, sir?
Once.
Yeah.
Sir, some sweaters or jackets will be more fluffy, na, sir?
Yeah.
Sir,
okay, I will share you these notes to the classroom, okay? Don't worry about that.
Sir, actually, I don't have classroom, sir. It's okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm, no problem. So generally what will happen? Wool?
Group, sir. Group.
Okay. Wool will hold a lot of air. Wool will hold the air. That air is acting as a bad conductor of heat, right?
Yes, sir.
Generally, air is a bad conductor of the heat. That will make the good insulator of the heat. Whatever the air, wool is air first. Wool will absorb the lot of air. But air is a bad conductor of heat. Right. That's why it will not transform the surrounding temperature to inside to the
body.
Body. Understanding. So we cannot feel that outside cool temperature will not enter into touch the body when you're wearing the woolen sweaters or woolen cloths.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Then quality of the wool will depend upon what?
Quality of wool depends on
how crimpy it is, sir.
How crimpy is it?
Age and the health condition of the animal. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
The quality of the wool always depends upon the three factors. First one is the health condition of the wool. Sorry, animal. Because healthy animals will produce a good quality wool, right? Because they don't have any disease. They don't have any other health issues. So they will produce a good quality of wool. So healthy of the animal is very important in the production of the wool. Next one.
So next one, the animal
has been
environmental factors.
Yes, sir.
The animal is grown.
Cold or...
Okay.
If it lives in the in mountains or Ladakh, because it has the bad conductor and it does not produce much heat to the body.
Yeah, because if you see the health environmental factors, like some places the environmental is very cool, like Himalayas, the temperature is very low. If you take the Ladakh, the temperature is higher. Rajasthan.
So then in mountain places, the yaks will have good condition and they can produce.
So the quality of the wool also will depends upon the the environmental factors in which the animals have been living. You can see the fluffy type of nature of wool whenever the animal is living in the cool places. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
The plain, the sweaters will be plain, which are getting from the yak or something, because they will mostly grown in the hot environment, like camel.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And what is the third one important one?
Sir, third one, sir. The part of the body of the animal which wool is obtained.
Okay. Suppose if you have the sheep, the shoulders of the sheep will have the different type of wool. The upper
the abdomen
part will have the different part of the different quality of the wool, right?
Yes, sir.
So because the top body of the sheep will expose to sunlight and water and everything, so it will have the different type of wool will get. What about the abdomen part?
Yes, abdomen part will not expose that much to sunlight and the ventilation.
So sir, my voice is breaking, sir.
What about my voice?
Most wool is found on the abdomen part of the sheep, sir.
Yeah. So we will get the good quality of the wool in the abdomen part of the sheep as well as on shoulders. Okay.
Yes, sir. One minute, sir.
What are the three important factors for the good quality of the wool?
Sir, the area the environment in which animal has been living, the part of the body of the animal from which wool is obtained.
Okay.
Sir, the age and health of the animal and the environment in which it lives and the part from which the wool is obtained, sir.
Okay, next one, last one is the part of the body of the animal.
Part of the body of the animal.
Which wool is obtained.
Body of the animal.
Then which part of the body, animal body, will get the soft wool?
Sir, shoulders, sir.
Shoulders, sir. Because it has soft.
Shoulders and the
shoulders.
Sides of the sheep.
The shoulders and the sides.
The sides means the body.
Yeah. Body sides or abdomen part of the sheep will get the good quality wool.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Any doubts in this?
No, sir. Sir,
no doubts,
sir. Sir, once you can show.
Sorry, once.
Yes, sir.
Sir, you can upload these notes in the group where we will check it out.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
I will upload in the classroom, okay? Don't worry.
Sir, don't upload in classroom, sir, because I don't have account.
Okay, just find out with the sir. Yeah. Just find out with the sir and you can take the account from that, okay? Don't worry. Okay, next one is a common source of wool. So, what are the common source of wool? I already given you homework, right?
Yes, sir.
Again, we'll discuss here. So these are some common sources of wool. What is the first one? Lambs.
Lamb.
So lamb is the sheep.
Sir, what are lambs?
Lamb is a baby sheep.
So generally, lamb is a baby sheep. So lamb wool comes from the bottom of the body of the sheep. It is very soft, long, and highly crimpled. So what is it say? You can say as it is a good quality wool or superior quality wool.
Sir, because its age is less and its health will also be good, sir.
Sorry?
Yes, sir.
Because its age is less and its health will also be good, sir.
The health of the sheep is also important, right? Generally, younger sheep will be more healthier than the older one, right?
Sir, even the wool will be very fresh. Sir, somebody is unmute and we can hear some voice. Kunal, sir.
So if you are not interested in the class, you can move out, but don't disturb others, okay?
Sir, I'm muted only.
Okay, don't sing the songs and all in the class, okay, first?
No, sir, not I, sir.
Okay, leave it. So come back to the topic. So what are the common sources of wool? So first one is the sheep.
Sir, lamb's wool comes from body of the sheep.
First one is the sheep. Second one is the
yak.
Yak. Okay, we'll go angora.
Yes, angora.
So angora is nothing but the angora rabbit or angora goat.
Sir, they are found in the place named angora, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, merino.
Angora rabbit.
Merino. Next one is a merino wool. Comes from the special breed of the sheep. In the merino is the one type of animal. I'll show you the pictures and all.
Sir, there is angora camel also, sir.
Okay, you can see this one, right? Merino is this.
Yes, sir. Angora camel is.
Sir, merino is another breed of sheep. Yeah. Sir, it's a breed name, merino sheep.
That's what I'm showing in the picture also, right? Okay, so first one is a sheep, next one is angora rabbit or angora goat, third one is a merino. What is a merino? Merino is generally breed in Australia. It will also have the highly crimpy, soft and fine texture. Okay, and the last, next one is a pashmina.
Yes, machino and sir,
so it is a soft and silky wool. Generally, it will grow in the hilly region, in the hilly and the cold region.
Like cashmere. So fussy, sir. Santosh
is the softest and the costliest wool.
Yes, sir.
Where will you get the Santosh?
Sir,
the Tibetan antelope, right? Tibetan plateau. So where is Tibet?
Sir, it is in Asia, sir. It is a side country, like it is a neighbor of India.
And this is above of the India, Tibetan plateau, right?
Yes, sir.
Tibetan.
Yeah, Tibetan plateau and all you study, right? Okay. So Santosh is a soft and the cost.
Sir, give me Santosh photo, sir, once.
Yeah, we'll find out. Okay, Santosh. Next one is a yak, and the last one is a camels. Generally, camel is used in the preparation of rugs and bed sheets.
Sir, can you show once?
I'll show you all the pictures, okay? Don't worry.
Sir, can you scroll up? Sir, can you take? I'll take screenshots.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
So what is the first one?
Sir, first one is
Angora rabbit.
Angora rabbit, right?
Sir, second one is.
Second one is
Angora goat, sir. Angora goat.
No, sir. Angora goat is the C1. Angora goat is the C1. It is a.
It is a merino. C1 is a merino.
Merino.
C1 is merino.
Second one is angora goat.
Yes, sir. I've seen that one.
Angora goat.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Third one is a merino.
Merino.
Famous in Australia.
Merino.
Next, fourth one.
Sir, next Tibetan one. Antelope. Tibetan antelope.
Lama.
Fourth one is a chiru.
Lama.
Sorry.
Lama, sir. Chiru.
Chiru. Fourth one is a chiru.
Yes,
and the fifth one is a alpaca.
Lama.
Yes,
what about this?
Ox oxen.
Ox or the hill goat.
Yeah.
And the last one is a.
Yeah.
Your camel is not given picture in the picture, okay?
Yes, sir. You know, sir, how camel looks.
Yeah, how the camel looks, you know, right?
Yes, sir.
So then what are the common source of wool? We have discussed 6 to 7 common source, right?
Sir, can you
put animal
sheep, lamb?
You can turn
angora
on your
angora rabbit, angora goat, merino, chiru.
Angora alpaca, rabbit, angora goat,
alpaca, hill merino, goats, and yak.
Chiru, alpaca. So these are some common animals which will get the wool.
Okay. Sir.
Here?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So general common shapes which you'll get in the Indian breeds is this one. Already I asked you to find out the homework, right? Lohi, Rampur, Nali, Makarwal, Marwari, Patanwadi.
Patanwadi.
So Lohi you get from the
sir?
Rajasthan and Punjab.
Sir?
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, I'm going to show everything from first. I will take screenshots, please.
So I will send you the notes in the Google Classroom, okay? Okay,
sir.
Okay.
No, sir. Wool, sir. Wool, sir. Mm-hmm.
We'll do it in the next half, last 10 minutes. Okay, don't worry in that.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, sir.
Okay.
Last 10 minutes, you can
see. So, what is the common source of wool in India? Some important sheep, sir.
Wool, sir. Tell me this.
Lohi, Patanwadi nail, Lohi,
Rampuri, Bushi,
Meringiri,
Muzaffarnagari, Bakharwal. Marwari,
Jaisal Mary, and the Munjal.
Patanwadi.
Hmm. So already there are some animals there and the sheep breeds and the states also given. Lohi from the Rajasthan.
Yes, sir.
Rampur from the Uttar Pradesh and Himachal Pradesh.
Yes, sir.
Nali from the? Rajasthan, Haryana, and Punjab.
Sir, I told this, sir. Sir, I told till fourth, I told everything, sir. I didn't tell Marwari, Patanwadi.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next, Bakarwal is from?
Sir?
When Kashmir, Bakarwal.
Yes, sir. Bakarwal and Nali.
So generally, Bakarwal wool is used in preparation of woolen shawls.
Bakarwal? So Jammu, Kashmir.
Yeah, Jammu and Kashmir state, but it's used in the preparation of woolen shawls. So Marwari is from the Gujarat. Yes, Patanwadi is from the also Gujarat.
Sir, Gujarat.
Okay, then how we will prepare from the fleece to the wool?
Yes, sir.
That is present processing of wool. So generally, yes, processing of wool takes place in the 5 steps. What are those 5 steps?
Shearing.
Sir, shearing.
So, first one is the?
Sir, first one is shearing, sir.
Shearing. 5 steps will be there.
It involves the removal of fleece
first
from
one.
The
processing.
Shearing.
Shearing.
Next one.
Scoring.
Sorting.
Yes.
Third one is.
Next one is boring. A washing. Next one is a.
Grading.
Sorting. The last one is a.
Yes, sir.
Grading.
Yes, sir.
Understand.
Yes, sir. 1 minute, sir. I will copy it on
there. Sir, can you show again? Just I'll copy. Sir, wait 1 minute.
Or else you can have this spinning. Spinning means?
Sir, spinning means?
First one.
Yeah.
Shearing.
So there are 5 steps in the processing of wool. First one is the shearing.
Sir.
Second one is the sorting.
Sir, sorting, washing.
Washing.
Sir, spinning.
Carding and the last one is a spinning.
Carding.
Spinning.
Sir, you can take out it.
Okay. So first one is the collagen shearing. What is the meaning of shearing?
The shearing, the involves of the removal of the fleece from the screen. The
removal of the fleece from the sheep. Body, sir.
Shearing means what?
Once in a year before the
summer.
Hey. You can speak one by one. Don't read the one. I'll explain, right?
Sir, can I? You are telling also, Sai Kartika is...
What is the meaning of shearing?
Sir, can I?
Shearing is nothing but removal of
fleece from sheep.
The removal of the
fleece from the
body of sheep.
And it is cut in 1/2 months.
Removal of the fleece from the
animals. Shearing. Sheep or yak or like that, sir. From sheep or yak.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
So shearing will be done with the help of what?
Mechanical shovel.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Shearing will be done with mechanical shears or machine. Because it is, there's a lot of disturbance and everybody are speaking at once and I can't hear anything which you say.
Okay, first boys, guys, sir, first of all, wait, listen first. First, let me explain the concepts, afterwards you speak, okay? If you are all speaking at the time, it will not be disturbance completely. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, I'm trying from another device.
So shearing means what? Removal of the fleece from the skin of the
sheep.
I will tell you, wait. So generally shearing will be done with the help of the
mechanical
or mechanical shears.
Yes, sir.
Okay. When the shearing process will start?
Sir, in the summer half month, sir. Summer,
so before the summer month, we'll do the shearing process. Why we do it only summer? Why not before winter?
Sir,
and
because that time heat will.
Sir,
be
because in the
sir before summer, because at summer time there will be more heat and it will time to grow of sheep, sir, like that. Hair will grow at that.
Kunal, wait. Aditi, are you there?
Yes, sir.
So I will call your name one by one. Then only you can respond here. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Aditi, are you there?
Yes, sir.
So
sir,
why
I'm
you want to do the shearing process
device
before the summer itself? Why not in the rainy season or winter season?
Sir, because their body needs air and the wool will protect as it will protect from cold or air to come. So they will take out their skin or the wool from in summer so that they can grow till winter and it, the cold, it will be protected. Their body will be protected.
Pranav?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what is the answer? Reason? That is the correct. Aditi, what you said? Pranav, what is your answer?